PJ's over there. I don't know if you want to talk to him first or after, but let me know when you're ready to see the body. I want to be there. Bufkin, do you have a second?
Of course, Miss Snow.
Oh, that's enough. Mira, vanish! Cancel! No.
What the hell are you doing?
What? I wasn't touching nothing.
What's going on?
Don't worry, no harm done. Right, Bigby?
We'll talk about this later.
TJ. It's all right. Are you ready to talk to Mr. Wolf? It's okay.
Are you okay?
Go ahead, TJ.
I go swimming at night sometimes, in the river. I wasn't doing anything bad, I promise.
Of course you weren't.
We know you're a good kid, TJ. You're okay.
Just tell me what you saw.
I was there, under the big blocks, and I heard noisy feet. And when I hear that, I'm supposed to go underwater and stay real still and quiet.
That's right, son.
Then I saw... I saw the lady!
It's okay, son. Careful, Bigby.
I wasn't.
I know.
The lady fell in, but she didn't have her head on. I thought she was gonna pull me down too. Cause she had rocks on her feet and she kept falling down in the dark parts.
Cinder blocks tied to her ankles. Is there more, TJ?
Is it true? You know when people are lying? I heard you could do that. That's why you're the sheriff.
Yeah, it's my special power. I always know when people aren't telling me the truth. Is there something else you want to say?
Please, don't be mad.
What is it, TJ?
I didn't stay under the water.
What?
I know I'm supposed to, but I was scared, and I went to the top again. I couldn't help it.
I gave you very specific rules. You have to stay quiet and out of sight or bad things can happen. I told you. It's dangerous out there. If someone saw you...
You're not in trouble.
Like Ellie's not.
Not this time, Toad.
So you didn't stay underwater.
I don't know if anyone saw me, but someone said, stop laughing. And then I was scared, and I went under for as long as I could.
Wait, you heard someone?
Yes.
Why didn't you tell us before?
I didn't want to be in trouble.
Did you hear anyone laughing?
No.
Did you see who it was?
No!
Sheriff.
Were those the same words they used? Stop laughing? Try to remember exactly what they said.
They said, stop laughing at me.
Bigby, he's frightened.
Do you know whose voice it was?
I don't know! I'm sorry. After I came up again, there was no one there. And I ran home, that's all. I promise!
I want to go home.
Okay, you can go.
Thank you, TJ.
Okay, son. Let's get you home.
Call us if you remember anything else.
Come on, then.
That went about as well as I expected. You want to go look at the body now? When you're ready.
Mirror.
Hello, Bigby. Nice to see you.
What were you showing Mr. Toad and his son?
Cinderella selling shoes, Rapunzel, Rose, and of course there's you. And I can't help note that you did not rhyme. Do try to stick to the rules next time.
Yeah, I'll do that. Where can I find Tweedledum? That piece of scum. The woodsman and I were fighting. Now I want to know where he's hiding. Well, that's helpful. Maybe this has been harder on him than I thought. Snow's perfume.
So, check out anyone who fits that profile. You might start with Bluebeard.
Right away, Miss Snow.
Are you ready to examine the body now?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness! I almost forgot.
Come on. I didn't realize. I've never seen her face before now.
Are you gonna be okay? You don't have to stay.
I want to stay. I'll be fine. It's just a little strange. The glamour is so effective, it's invasive. But Just do what you need to do. That's weird. I don't wear a brooch like that.
Maybe it really belonged to her. Not part of the glamour.
Looks like something from the homelands. Bufkin, do you recognize these symbols?
No, nothing I've seen before.
It looks just like Faith's did. Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
No. He said he wanted to run more tests. If the neck wound was the same, there might be a ribbon in her mouth, too. Anything?
Nothing. So, it's not exactly the same.
Can you close her mouth? Thanks.
Track marks.
She used Mundy drugs?
Looks that way. Pretty heavily, too. I hear they only go for the legs if they've used up the veins in their arms, or if they're trying to hide the marks.
Wait. If the glamour is supposed to make her look like me, shouldn't it be concealing things like track marks? That brooch, too. Why would it change everything else? I've never seen one this sloppy.
Might be a cheap one, just to get the job done.
The witches upstairs know what they're doing, that's why they cost so much. Unless someone is making glamours illegally?
It's not technically illegal, miss. It's not encouraged, for sure, but there aren't any laws specifically forbidding it.
So there's some sort of black market for glamours?
One would assume so. I imagine anyone with access to the proper books and training could theoretically produce a glamour.
Yet another thing to worry about. Black market or not, it's a pretty good match. Look at that. The buttons aren't exact either. There's an extra one here.
Rope marks.
She was tied up?
They tied cinder blocks to her ankles, so she would sink.
Oh.
Her fist is clenched.
So she fought back?
No marks on the knuckles.
Oh.
Maybe she was grabbing something?
Maybe. What are you doing?
Only way to find out.
Jesus, Bigby. What is it? Flowers.
Yeah. You're right. These buttons are wrong. I wonder...
What?
Snow, do you mind if I, open her coat?
Bigby, just let me do it.
It's not you, Snow. It's just a body.
Well, I certainly hope you're behaving yourself up here. What have you found out? Well?
Her glamour is defective.
Defective?
We're thinking it's black market. We should really be regulating this kind of thing.
Yes.
We should keep going.
What is that?
It's your perfume.
How do you know what perfume I wear?
You can't fool this nose. Also, I saw the bottle on your desk. Looks like someone picked it out for her.
So, someone gave her instructions. I've seen things like this before. It's definitely magic. Though witches don't usually craft objects these days.
I don't think it's wise to fool around with that. It's some kind of black market magic. Who knows what it could do? We should have it looked at. Just to make sure it isn't dangerous. Don't you think?
You may be right. One way to find out.
What?
There's something in here.
How do we open it?
Might want to stand back if you're worried, Crane. I'm gonna try to open it. Something to do with these rings here.
Deer. What does that mean? Oh. Is that...
It's your hair.
Someone must have taken this from my apartment. I noticed it was missing, but I didn't think. This was the last picture I had of Rose and me. My sister and I don't talk much anymore. Who did this, Bigby?
She's a troll?
You gotta be kidding me.
Yeah, she's a troll. Can we move on?
Who is she? That wasn't there before. Who do you think she is? I don't know many trolls, I'm afraid.
Should have left them all back in the homelands.
You don't mean that, do you?
Maybe Holly knows.
The owner of the Trip Trap? No, she looks a little... Oh no.
What is it?
It's not Holly, it's her sister Lily. She was reported missing, but I guess it just slipped through the cracks.
We have to go tell Holly.
Right. Who knows? She might know something about this. Who Lily was seeing.
Well, certainly another troll.
We should go.
You can't go out there.
Why not?
It's too dangerous. Someone tried to kill you. Bigby, you can't let her go out there with you. You'd be putting her life at risk.
Bigby is not in charge of me.
He's in charge of this investigation.
That's not the same thing.
If Snow wants to come with me, I'm not gonna stop her.
But...
We should leave now. You ready?
Yeah.
This whole thing is complete bullshit, and always has been. I mean, what's his job, really?
To keep shit from reaching the woodlands. Jack, I don't know where they are.
You're a bar. You're supposed to have darts around.
And I normally do, but who knows where the fuck they went to after...
Come on, Holly. I need entertainment. This'll do.
Holly, you got a minute?
Why?
Please, Holly. It's important.
Miss White! I heard you had kind of a strange morning.
It's been kind of a strange morning for everyone, I think.
Every time I see this guy, he seems to lose weight. It's amazing. It really is. He loses weight and yet somehow keeps all the muscle.
Jack.
Wolfie, my dear, how are you? Because, you know, we were just talking about you. All of us. At the bar, here. About you.
Not too good right now.
Well, that's sad to hear. Me? Oh, I'm great, as usual.
Uh-huh.
I'm dying to hear about the body that came out of the East River this morning. It was a fable, right? Oh, everyone knows.
Tweedledee was just here.
He said it looked like Snow White.
What the hell, Crane?
Sorry.
Tweedledee said you arrested him for no earthly reason. Kept him locked in the cellar all fucking night. He said you tortured him. Which, I don't know, that seems like a breach of your legislative duties. Bigby, come on. You can't be so dumb as to-
Jack, find the off button, now!
What is it with you two? You and Gran are all, let's get a posse together when there's no one around. But as soon as the big bad wolf walks in, your tails go between your legs. Cat got your nerve? What happened?
What happened? I'm tired is what happened.
Tired of what?
Of trouble, Jack. I'm sick and tired of trouble. I don't want any more. So just stop revving his motor or wait outside or fuck the hell off. I don't care which.
Both of you, listen.
Bigby, look. Two fables are dead. And shit, Gren's sister...
Holly's sister.
Holly's sister has been missing for what? A few days now? And we haven't heard word one about it from anyone.
Actually... Have there been any updates on my sister?
I don't know how to say this to you, Holly. The woman we found in the river.
Who was it?
You know who it was.
Boy, I sure walked into that one.
If you say one more fucking thing, just one more thing, God fucking damn it! Of course, the dear princess, Snow fucking White, is all safe and sound. Where were you when we reported this weeks ago, huh? Where are you when we ever fucking need you? If you'd give 1 ounce of a shit about her, about any of us, she might have been saved. She might have been cared for. She might have been...
I'm sorry, Holly. I'm sorry we found your sister this way, and I wish this had ended up better.
Holly.
Get the fuck out of my bar.
I just want-
It should have been you. It should have been you, and it wasn't.
We recovered this from her personal effects. I thought you might like to have it.
I didn't know she still had this. The copper was from a dwarf mine. It's very rare and very old.
It's quite lovely.
Gren.
Yeah?
Take off for a bit, would you?
Are you sure?
I don't know that much about her life. Honestly, we didn't talk often. She was lost here, in the city. She just got swept away by it.
Why were you two not talking?
It seems so fucking petty now, but I didn't want to watch it with her. I think she was off the Monday drugs, but she was hooking to pay down debt. It ate me up to see her that way. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie. The owner, Georgie, with all his fucking fees, it's a crock of shit. That's how they kept her under their thumb, really.
Holly, it's okay. If it's too much, we don't have to do this.
Georgie. What do you know about him?
We can just go talk to him. We've got a lead. Maybe we can take it from here.
Lily.
Anything else you can tell us?
I don't think so. Like I said, we didn't talk much.
That's all right. You've been more than helpful.
Is she? Where is she?
She's at the business office. She's taken care of.
I'm gonna have to go down there and get her. Fuck.
Please, we can handle the funeral arrangements.
No. It's a kind of... It's a formality with trolls. We burn our dead by sunrise, or... I don't know. Some old world shit will fuck your soul up.
Of course.
Okay. Good.
Let's go down to the business office and start making the necessary preparations, all right? That club?
I'll go down there now. See what I can find out from the owner.
You were good with her. I'm impressed. Really, thanks. It just made everything easier.